Africa in Motion is presenting today Perdouxis. This condition is among the top 10 killer disease in Africa in developing countries. That's why it is one of our priorities. Let's see these five questions so that you can understand this condition. What is Perdouxis? What causes Perdouxis? What are the signs and symptoms? And what are the complications? And how is it treated or prevented? Let's see, we are going to see this condition into two parts. In part one, we're going to see the definition and the causes. What is Perdouxis? Perdouxis commonly is known as a whooping cough. It is a respiratory tract infection characterized by paroxysmal cough, a continuous cough. It's a difficult one. It was first identified in the 16th century, 400 years ago. The Perdouxis will be having non-stop persistent cough. It's very distressing. Whooping cough or Perdouxis gets its name from this word whoop. It's a sound that a person, typically children, the child will make a sound that causes gasp after coughing, you know, gasping for the air. Whooping cough is a bacterial infection. It's not a viral infection. So this infection will infect the respiratory tract and it will cause this severe cough we are talking about. It is very contagious. It is spread by coughing or sneezing. It causes epidemic. Okay, it can also be sporadic. Epidemic, we are meaning condition that can affect many people at a certain region, at a certain period in time. But it's sporadic now, it can just affect one person here and jump affect another one in another province. Those are the sporadic cases. So the bacteria, this bacilli called the Bordetella pertussis, will produce biologically active substances. Let's call them toxins. These toxins will cause inflammation of the respiratory system. It will be after infection, inflammation will start. Then it will create what we call patchy necrosis in this respiratory tract. From the nostril, going down to the pharynx, going down to the bronchi. Then it will create a mucopurulent secretions, mucus and pus. Then it will cause the bronchoconstriction. This area will be constricted. It might cause what we call atelectasis. These organ, the terminal part of the respiratory tree, will collapse and form one unit, atelectasis. Now, this Bordetella, this bacilli, once it is on the epithelium, the lining membrane in the respiratory way from the nostril, nasopharynx, going down to the hypopharynx, going to the larynx, entering the trachea, it will start causing problems. We know that there is what we call the cilia. The cilia, the part which help to clean up, but the bacteria will come and get attached to this membrane, then start causing the disorder of the function of this epithelium by secreting some toxins that will destroy that area. So what causes Perdouxis? Let's just get into details a little bit on the causes. The main cause is this bacilli called Bordetella pertussis. It was discovered by Bordet, isolated it in 1906. So this bacilli will be causing this infection. It's a gram negative. It's gram negative because of what is found when you are doing a microscopic examination. It remains red after coloration. This is how it will look like when you are examining on a microscope. You can see now when it is invading the respiratory tree, then it starts destroying it and causing a very severe cough. Now, it will be spread by either coughing or sneezing. We call it airborne disease. It's via aerosolized droplets. Those small droplets, though you don't see them, but they might move from a person to another one. So then after it is attached to the epithelium of the respiratory tree, it starts causing the disorders of the function of the respiration. Now, if a person is infected, coughs out, the person in the proximity will breathe in, then get this infection and start causing this problem of coughing. So we saw a little bit about the definition and the causes. Let's see the clinical sign and symptoms, complications, then treatment in part two. Please don't miss it. Health education and health promotion.